You can tell the direction the downtown is headed by simply just seeing what's going on. Often it's just a matter of seeing construction, renovations, street improvements. Downtown Pittsfield has had all of that over the last decade, and it was the administration of Jim Roberto that spurred a lot of it along, and it included public but a lot of private investment that did follow suit after the public push came first. So we're still seeing it today. We're still seeing investment. Hotel on North is one of those areas, but all kinds of market rate housing. So it's active.
Right, and I think we're somewhere in the ballpark of probably $100 million in investment in the last 10 years, yeah. Right? So when you're dealing with any kind of revitalization of a downtown, that public-private partnership is really important and key. It's not just one entity's responsibility. There has to be a collaboration there, and there has to be a real vision. And everyone has to agree that this is kind of the direction we're going. And I think here we're really starting to see that we have property owners that are fully invested in our downtown. We have our historic building. We have a lot of historic buildings here. Sure. In downtown. Beautiful, beautiful architecture in our downtown. But, they're renovating those first floors for commercial, retail, restaurant, and then upstairs for the market rate housing. And, Allegrona Construction, for example, they just finished what we call the Howard Building. Beautiful market rate housing, apartments up there that they didn't even stay vacant for long enough for their open house.
Yeah. They sold immediately.
Yeah.
And it's interesting because, we did touch on the market rate housing before and how people are living in the downtown, but interestingly, that was never possible up until about a decade ago. For when the city council and the administration at the time said, hey, we want to create a zoning area that will allow this mixed use. So, so those are the things that government can do
to help out.
Yep. But then, obviously the private investment has to follow suit.
Right, right. And to go along with that, obviously streetscape improvements make a huge difference. So in our downtown in particular, there was a lot of infrastructure change that needed to happen in order to, I guess, kind of roll with the current current times, yeah. While maintaining our character. I mean, we have these really beautiful historic buildings, like I said, and so we don't want to undo the character of the city while we're, making these improvements and trying to move forward. We want to maintain who we are.
It is interesting because during urban renewal, there was a mentality that said, let's bring everyone as quickly as possible through North Street. And of course, we know in the decades since then that was a mistake, and that the idea for a downtown should be, no, let's slow people down. Let's make sure they're able to see what's in the downtown and be able to stop and walk in the downtown to make sure it's a pedestrian-friendly neighborhood, as it were. So, some of what we've done is sort of undid the old philosophies. And urban renewal, of course, was that time when it seemed like we did everything wrong.
right.
Late 60s, early 70s.
Exactly. And I think, you sort of find this in every, just trends in general. We do things for a while and then we realize, oh, this is somehow moving us in a direction we don't want to go. And then, new trends will begin. And it's in every facet of life, whether it's, in retail, like we were talking about earlier, or fashion, to just, urban development. And the other great thing about our downtown is the investment we made in our big park in downtown, the Common.
We'll talk more about that, because green space is a big part of our downtown. So let's continue our conversation and hit on that.